Good morning to all of you. Now we are going to continue the remaining controls of the Android Studio. So let's start the Android Studio. So in the last session we have seen the controls, the common, text and button. Common controls are nothing but which are the common from all the controls. These are displayed over here. We have seen the text controls also, we have seen the buttons also. The buttons like image button or the radio button or a radio button group or the chip group. So like this we have seen the controls or the checkboxes. Now we are going to talk about the gadgets. The first, that's a view. What kind of view you want, you can just drag and drop the view control over here. Now second, that's the image view. Now again, image view is nothing but the image you want that will be displayed over here. So the image view, already we have seen this control. Next, that's a web view. Suppose you want to display any HTML web page, you can use a web view. Next, that's a video view. Suppose you want to use any video for the playing purpose on app, you can use the video view. Next, that's a calendar view. You can just drag and drop the calendar, you will get a display of the calendar. Next, that's a progress bar. Whenever there is a background work is there, you can just drag and drop the progress bar. So until the background work is finished, the progress bar is going to continue as a waiting purpose. So next, that's a progress bar horizontal. So when you drag and drop the horizontal progress bar, it is going to display in the horizontal purpose. So these are the main controls from the gadgets. We will talk these controls one by one later also, when we are going to design any application and how we are going to use these controls. We are going to talk for that, for these controls also. So suppose I want the calendar control, just I'm going to add the activity. So just drag and drop, right click on the app. Now click new and click on the activity, get the empty activity. I'm keeping main activity file as a name as it is, and I'm going to finish it. Now the new activity has been added. So activity 5. Now here you can drag and drop the controls from here. So suppose I want a calendar control, you can just drag and drop the calendar control over here. It is going to place the control like this. You can make that this as a pop-up also. If you get the error, you will just click on the infer constant, the error will be removed. The same for the video view also. Just drag and drop this control, and at the background you can give the location of the video. Now whenever you are going to add any video, you have to make sure that this video should be present in the folder. So that folder will be in the resources. So in the resources folder, you can place this folder also. Suppose you want to use the SD card, then you have to make some changes in the emulator also. So when we are going to write the actual program for the video view, we are going to talk on this also. Next, that's a web view. Now this web view is nothing but the image, HTML page, it is going to display as a web view. So the HTML page, it is going to display it. So these are some kind of gadgets. Next, that's a layout. Now from the layout, first by default is a constraint layout. So the constraint layout is nothing but what will be the position according to the other layout that we want to display or that we want to give in the constraint layout. So by default it is a constraint layout. Next, that's a guideline, that is horizontal layout and vertical layout. Next, that's a linear layout and horizontal vertical. Now linear layout means you have to drag, when you drag and drop the controls, it will be displayed one by one or line by line. For example, suppose I want this as a linear layout. When I place a linear layout, and when I'm going to add the controls, it will be line by line. So like this, the controls are added. So this will be the linear layout. Linear layout means when you drag and drop the controls, first it will get entire position, that is horizontal and entire width or entire width for the control, and next the other control is placed. So that will be the linear layout. And exactly opposite is horizontal layout. When you make the horizontal layout, these controls will be placed in the horizontal position. Next, that's a frame layout. You can make, or you can make the fragment of the layout, and you can make two or three frames, and here you are going to display the layout. Next, that's a table layout and table row. Table layout means here we have to specify the height and width of the table and number of rows and number of columns of the table, and accordingly you can place the controls in each and every row. The same for the table row. For the table row also, you can just drag and drop the table row. For example, suppose I want a table row, you can just make the drag and drop, and when you see over here, you will get a table row. So here you want to specify the row number, and in one row how many controls you want to add. So like this, you can make the table layout. Now next, that's edge space, that is horizontal space. How much space you want from the horizontal, that we want to apply by using this layout. So this was about the basics of the layout. Again, we are going to go depth in the layout also, because in this lecture we are going to talk about the basic interaction of all these controls. So when we do the programming one by one, we are going to talk on each and every control in detail. But mostly we are concentrating on regularly used layouts or regularly used controls. Next, that's a controller. Now here you are getting some of the controls like a spinner. Spinner control is nothing but whenever you are going to use the list, you are going to use the spinner control. Again, the scroll view, horizontal scroll view, nested scroll view, these are also related to the layout. So next, that's a Google. Now whenever you want to work on the application where you want to use a Google map, then you can just drag and drop the map view. Now when you use a map and map view, you have to do one thing. Just we have to get the Google key so that the map will be displayed over here. Now when you are going to add the Google key, that will be added in the manifest file. In the Gradle file, because here we want to add the extra libraries for the Google Play services. So whenever you are going to work on the map, first we have to make the implementation of this Google. Now the net connections is not available, so that's why it is going to give the error, because unable to resolve dependency. The dependency is not yet downloaded. So when you make the Gradle synchronization, this dependency will be added automatically and this service will be downloaded. So whenever you want to work on the Google Maps, you have to first drag and drop the Google map. Before that, you have to get the Google key for the mapping purpose, and when you drag and drop it, the external libraries will be downloaded automatically by using Gradle. So this was about the basics of these controls. From next lecture onwards, we will talk on one application and how we are going to design that application. We are going to use that control from that perspective, so that we will learn more or depth on the controls. So this was end of the lecture. If you have any doubts, any question, you can put on the comments. Thank you.